be next.
And joining me now are West Virginia Congresswoman Shelley Moore Capito and Fox News Radio's Todd Starnes. Great report, by the way, Todd. Thank you. In his report, he's talking about generations of coal miners. Right. He's talking about a way of life under attack, how people feel. 12% unemployment and using the term all-out war.
Right.
Is that what it is? Is the administration all-out war on coal?
It is a war on America's energy, and it's a war on coal. And these are communities that are blessed with a natural resource, that want to live and work in a community that they love, where their families are from, and they're having to leave. I mean, just in the last month, at least 1,000 laid off coal miners. Those are families.
How many years in terms of independence would we have if we were to tap the resources in this country?
Well, I think there's estimates to 250 years.
250 years?
Yes.
And it's clean. In other words, this is clean burning coal. We have the ability.
We have the ability. We can do better at that. I mean, I think there's more technology and research, but not if you don't fund the technology and research, not if you move forward. I had an experimentation in my district on coal sequestration. They had to pull the plug on it because the dollars weren't there. It's not economically feasible. So we've got to move forward on this. I mean, I think it's detrimental to us.
I'm watching your report closely, Todd, and what are the people on the ground in West Virginia saying? You know, Joe Manchin has to run almost like a conservative, shoot a gun in a commercial, and say he's against cap and trade to even have a chance of getting elected. But then he votes with the Democrats on, you know, raising taxes on, quote, the wealthy business owners in the country. What are they telling you on the ground about President Obama?
They're upset. And look, these are not closed-minded people we're talking about. This was a community that voted for President Obama. They believed the hope and the change that he promised, and that never came. The numbers speak for themselves. The unemployment rate in Boone County was 4% when
12% now.
12% now. 12%. And the cold, hard reality is that these policies, this war that he's declared on their way of living, is taking food off the table. People are having to go somewhere else to find work, to raise their families, and people are very, very concerned about what's going to happen.
You know, I met Mr. Blankenship, who's one of the bigger coal miners going back a few years, and I gave a speech with him. I mean, he described it as an all-out war. And he said, I got all these guys, I want to keep working. I can't do it.
No, and they're closing up shop. They can't get the permits. They can't burn it. We've had coal-fired power plants closed down in our whole region. And another thing, the president's picking winners and losers in this country when he does this.
Yeah.
Because it's the heartland of America.
Cylinder's the winner. Big bundles
exactly.
Are winners. You know, green energy are winners.
Right.
Finland's a winner. Brazil's a winner, right? It's crazy. Good to see you both.
Thank you.
Good report, Todd.
Thanks.
Thank you. And coming up, we're going to wrap things up with our studio audience and much more. Thank you for being with us on this special edition of Hannity.